Good day, dear citizens. Thomas Churchyard here, ready to report on the next stage of our royal progress. Today is Monday, 11th of August. Our visit to Bury St Edmunds was subdued. Her Majesty had been unwell and communications had been frustratingly slow. During our stay at Bury St Edmunds, we took a short trip to Euston Hall. The Queen's mood was fortuitously lifted. Dinner was a delight, and the following day the Queen hunted across Euston's impressive 200-acre deer park, most invigorating. So it was no surprise when our host at Euston, William Drury, was knighted by Elizabeth before returning to Bury St Edmunds. Our next stop takes the progress 10 miles further into North Suffolk, to Mr Rookward's hall at Euston. Here, there has been an unpleasant discovery that has unsettled an otherwise pleasant stay. Has there been a court conspiracy to frame Mr Rookward? Maybe you can work it out as we join Queen Elizabeth, Lord Burghley and the Earl of Leicester as they prepare to depart from Euston Hall.
This vile idol, who in this house or this dreadful village has been worshipping her in the shadow of my presence?
We do not know, Majesty.
Well, how was it found then? Has Walsingham ordered a search? I've had nothing to suggest such an action.
It was well hidden in the hayrick, madam. It is of poor adornment, not likely recently used.
Are you trying to excuse it, Burley?
But Majesty, no. We were simply looking for a piece of your plate which had gone missing.
Stolen is the word you were reaching for, my lord.
Quiet, Robin. Unless you know something about this, do you? Have you had word from Walsingham about a plot to frame this family, who are already excommunicated Catholics? Why such an effort to chastise them?
How could you think that I would not have told you of such a plot? I am not his only contact. He has spies everywhere. We all know that.
Oh, fine. So whose spy is it then, Leicester? Yours? Hatton's? Churchyard's?
Your Majesty, do not distress yourself. You have my word that there is no deception. I admit that our search in the haystack was a little off the beaten track.
Although it has revealed Master Rookwood's intention to continue to worship by the old religion, Bishop Freke has no excuse but to punish him now.
Before we leave, see to it that it is burned to my content and before the sight of the whole village. It might be some rough copy belonging to a lower type, or it might be Rookwood's ruse to trick us all into thinking so.
Majesty.
And what of my silver plate, Robin? I've heard nothing of its return.
I heard it was overlooked. Your royal plate is all packed and ready to journey onwards. This is all a triumph, really.
What are you talking about, Robin?
Well, Bess, it appears you have found a wooden needle in a Catholic haystack.
You are wicked, sir.
Come now, calm yourself. Sit and make ready for our departure. For we must journey onwards to Norfolk. It will be a pleasure. And I only hope that our Norfolk pleasure does not see the loss of another of your Majesty's fans.
Oh, do not tease me, sir. I was saddened to lose that fan, and at mine own fault. But the sight of Sir William rushing around in the murky depths trying to retrieve it, it was almost worth it.
The fire has been set, Majesty. Up here, look. It will take a little while for the flames to take hold, and that will delay us. But if your Majesty needs to see it destroyed, then that is a small price to pay. What do you say, Leicester? May this delay be communicated to the Sheriff of Norfolk?
Yes, I shall send word immediately. Wrap up well, your Majesty, for the weather is turning, and there will be a chill in the air by the time we reach the Norfolk border. Burley?
Yes, sir. Before your Majesty presents yourself at this sacrifice, may I take this moment to inform you of the planned reception of Norfolk as we cross the border? We will be met at the county boundary by the Sheriff of Norfolk, and Churchyard has informed me that the Sheriff will be accompanied by 2,500 horsemen, no less, including 600 mounted gentlemen.
Oh, that is a lot of gentlemen. But then again, Churchyard is rather prone to exaggerating all his details.
The Norfolk citizens have heard how dutifully their Suffolk neighbours received you, and have prepared to show themselves as dutiful and honoured by your presence in their county.
I had a letter from Sir Nicholas Estrange, who is travelling all the way from King's Lynn to join us for Norwich and Thetford, just one of many travelling in this way to honour our visit. I must say, Burley, I marvel at where they all might lodge.
At Kenning Hall, camps have been reserved for the gentlemen and their horses. I only hope that this will be downwind of your Majesty's chambers.
Well, if the Howards' history of treason with my family is anything to go by, I think your hopes may be in vain, Burley. Now, am I fit to meet all these swooning gentlemen?
A prince indeed, madam.
There is only one way to guard against flattery, and that is by making sure your men understand that telling you the truth will not offend you. Understood?
Never a truer word spoken, Majesty.